Man centraal op het middenveld bij Nigeria wist die bal op te pikken. Atinga. Doet dat uitstekend. Wel een vrije trap. Okoro. Deze. Goeie lange bal van achteruit. Opoto. Een uur onderweg. En nu mag het. Het fluitje heeft geklonken. Atinga en 2-0. Ghana op een 2-0 voorsprong in de finale.
Tournament's been such a success, but I suppose in the wider world, the bigger picture again is that there are players who know that they're being watched further afield, and those maybe who dreamt two or three years ago of a big move to Europe. May's tournament's been such a success, but I suppose in the wider world, the bigger picture again is that there are players who know that they're being watched further afield, and those maybe who dreamt two or three years ago of a big move to Europe. May's watching, not getting much involvement now. He does perhaps not really imposing himself much down this left side, is he, for Ghana?
Ben. But he wants to much central and control affairs, but because the coach really wants
Nigeria with lots of well-rehearsed set pieces, well, you may not have the people out there to employ them anymore.
Well, definitely. And maybe you still can count on Okoro. But if you look at their left-back position there with Akas coming in, James Daniel started looking award. I'm not too sure Lobby Stars. Maybe they had someone who was feeding him with the balls and he was quite getting the goals for them. But at the national level, he's not doing that.
Pacey John was on the run outside, but it didn't reach him. Saying to Nigeria, look, you're the team that's got to win it. You come on to us. More and more it's going long from back to front for Nigeria, and I'm not sure that's working out for them. A little bit lively when it came in his direction. But very good work once more by Atinga.
Very strong sloppiness in Ghana's defence. Atinga just failing to get the ball away from Okoto. And Okoto showed a lot of strength in there.
Fresh zip in the legs now for Ghana as well as Ali goes for it. Decisions mean so much. Big decisions, big moments in games like this with so much on the line. The decision not to give a penalty at one end. Not to sanction the goalkeeper and Nigeria.
Ping to the own half. Not a long ball, beautifully tapped by Alassan Samake. Looking for him to hit this one in. Atinga with that header back into play. And the Malians looking to use the
Namara Male, the number 7, also left side of midfield.
Moussa Koné always will love to go beyond the back line of the and straight to Djigui. It's looking promising for Ghana, isn't it?
Yeah, that's the best chance they've had so far. 11 minutes in.
Kisaka Sameko. He's trying to make sure Ali's Moussa Koné will get some of the ball, but Sana Samake, Moussa Koné, Atinga with a high ball in. Mali flag stay down for Moussa Koné. Kida arriving, and Mali would have a Niang. It's been a lot of a
well, he went too early, was offside.
Going under, trying to go in again, but Yusuf Traore play it away.
Well, he went too early, was offside.
going under, trying to go in again, but Yusuf Traore play it away. Woof, Winfield coming up, will be my man, perhaps.
Must be.
Kizito will definitely leave it up for Tinga to head it back in. And woof, Winfield coming up, will be my man, perhaps.
Must be.
Kizito will definitely leave it up for Tinga to head it back in. And
anticipa così Felix Addo, rimane a terra il numero 9. Tum, Lomotey, Samuel Sarfo, ed è logico perché stiamo parlando dei giocatori migliori di queste nazionali, però qui si abbia un occhio di riguardo per il campionato della nazionale della nazione ghanese. Ce l'hai con un giocatore dilettantistico, ma che comunque giocava a calcio, il fisico perfetto, quello di un poliziotto perfettamente in forma. Di fatto poi nel giro di un anno ha effettuato un salto clamoroso. Nabi rinvia, non benissimo, Ismael Sillà però anticipa Felix Addo, deve tenerla in campo Seydouba, trova ancora Ismael Sillà, non aiutato dal campo, quindi non riesce a controllare bene. Quanto spinge però Nabi, colpevole sul gol dell'1-0, inchiodato in area di rigore, fatto troppo facilmente anticipare da Stephen Sarfo. Patrick Razak, un altro esterno, non cambia nulla a livello tattico. C'è la punizione, battuta in area di rigore, Atinka ci arriva. Seydouba, di là se la cava ancora una volta. Seydouba, si là, gli dà una mano lungo la stessa corsia, poi prova ad inventare. Trova il movimento di Kassori. Altra chiusura della difesa del Ghana, Nabi un po' in difficoltà, ancora con Stephen Incha, Frimpong pressato in maniera regolare, secondo l'arbitro da Ndiaye, che poi prova a far correre in verticale Kassori, c'è spazio per andare al cross, c'è però Atinga sulla sua strada, non evita il calcio d'angolo, però chiude il difensore centrale. Ndiaye salta con Kinga, alla media difensore centrale del Ghana.
Yip inside when Wadibosa whipped in. Well defended, beautiful. That's the best of strikes there from Isaac Chim.
But you never know what's going to happen when you take a shot like that outside.
And only as far as Chim. Possession one back. Saliban, ball lifted, dip inside, jump in there. And well defended by Atinga. Dokoli. In Ghana, having clean sheets, good one for Joseph Addo. Really spend a lot of time in Ghana. Well, lovely here. Right again, I think I would have to come in with a deception. And that's where Nabi tackle play of the Black Stars. Pajob and Vincent, I think, are struggling to win possession, but I think against a bit of Pajob, put pressure on the defense of the Gambia, Patrick Razak. Again, Razak trying to cut deep. He's going to work hard and come to with a strike, and Ghana still piling pressure. Incredible job to keep their defense pretty well stabilized. And Patrick Razak again, well, cutting to nobody. And the Gambia is trying to get the ball out of the next round of the competition here. It has been really nerve-wrenching game. Vincent Atinga. And Atinga calmly slot the ball home for a first goal of the WAPU tournament.